Dear Elder Shonetani Mori, dear Elder Moli, you are here called to serve as a missionary of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. You are assigned to labor in the New Zealand Hamilton.
Yes! I called it! I called it! Woo!
It is anticipated that you will serve a period of 24 months. You will report to the Provo Missionary Training Center on Wednesday, January 15th of 2014. You will prepare to preach the gospel in a Tongan language.
Told you, Sione. I told you.
Your assignment may be modified according to the needs of the mission president. You have been recommended as one worthy to represent the Lord of the Minister of the Restored Gospel. You will be an official representative of the church. As such, you will be expected to maintain the highest standards of conduct and appearance by keeping the commandments, leaving the mission rules, and following the counsel of your mission president. As you devote your time and attention to serving the Lord, leave behind all other personal affairs. The Lord will bless you with increased knowledge and testimony of the restoration of the truth of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Your purpose will be to invite others to come into Christ by helping them receive the restored gospel through faith in Jesus Christ and his atonement, repentance, baptism, receiving the gift of the Holy Ghost, and enduring to the end. As you serve with all your heart, might, and strength, the Lord will lead you to those who are prepared to be baptized. The Lord will reward you for your goodness of your life. Greater blessings and more happiness than you have yet experienced await you as you humbly and prayerfully serve the Lord in his labor of love among his children. We place our confidence in you and pray that the Lord will help you become an effective missionary. You will be set apart as a missionary by your state president. Please send your written acceptance promptly, endorsed by your bishop. Sincerely, Thomas Munson. Just like to thank my Heavenly Father for this great blessing and opportunity. All my life I've been preparing for this moment, and now that it's here, I get to go help and save people in New Zealand. And I guess part of my prayers were answered because I asked God to please let me learn my own language, my own culture. And he's blessed me this day with this opportunity to go and serve. And I'm so, so blessed. And I thank you all, and I say this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.
Willie, come here. This is Sonny's best friend. I'll give him a minute to.
Oh man, I don't think I'm supposed to cry at his. Closer,
Willie.
I've known Sione for a long time, since we were like this long. And I don't know, he's changed my life. He's been a good example to me since we've been growing up. Kind of like another brother that I never had. And the moment he said New Zealand kind of hit me that we've been together since we were little, no one to separate us. This is going to be the first time we've been apart. Kind of weird. Not having, we're going to have different companions for once. I just want to thank Sione for everything he's done for me, even though I haven't been as great as I could have been to him. He's always been there for me through thick and thin. Every bad time that I've had in my life, he's always been there to give me advice and help me through everything. And honestly, I think New Zealand is going to get the best missionary in the world. And I think, luckily, his prayers have been answered through everything he's asked for. Before he went on his mission, we had a little bump in the road, and I was scared to think that I would leave before him. I didn't want to leave him behind. I just want to thank him for everything, and thanks, Dad, for giving me this opportunity. Yeah, be a good missionary.
Thank you, Willie. I know Bishop Rick, they need to go. I'll just give the last time to Bishop before they go to their Bahamafulu thing. And after they will go from there. This is a family thing. And I want to have a meeting with the Bishop before he left.
I want to thank President for wanting to include me in this. How grateful I am for Sione to know him. And yes, him and Willie are inseparable. So from here, and then they even work together at the same company right now, preparing for their mission. So, but I know whatever the Lord has for them, they'd be more than willing to serve. I know that they are worthy, they're ready, and I couldn't have known any better prepared missionary yet but these two. So for them, I'm truly grateful for their example for the younger one that are coming up, and for being a part in their life in this time. For that, I'm grateful that I live with you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Well, thank you so much, families, relatives, and ward members, for being here. This is the real story right there. It's not Hawaii. New Zealand mission. So, like Willie said, they're really best friends. I know, like Willie said, they had some up and down. They help each other. And they really do. I want to thank my wife, the mother of our family, for all she has done teaching my kids. I was a busy man working, church calling, but she always at home take care of our kids. So now this is our youngest son, and I want to thank our parents, grandpa and grandma. This is their boy, it's not our boy. This is grandma and grandpa's son, baby. So, thank you, my sister Lita, and the kids, being here, and all the friends in Granger 8th Ward. I'm so proud of this boy. I won't miss him, but he's a good miss. There's no one we can bully. This boy is different from my other kids. My other kids, I say something, they talk back to me. Let me tell you, it's true. This boy, I say something to him, my wife, Lola, Etu, and Alo, he go. He don't even say anything. No complaint, he just goes. So, Sione, we love you. We're so proud of you. Bishop, thank you. Again, he's the one who wrote the keys. Bless the life of our family, especially this young man. As you know, my kids, they're not perfect. They make mistakes, a lot of mistakes. And the bishop, with the keys he's holding, he blessed the life of this young man to be worthy and clean so we can go and serve the Lord. So, again, I don't want to make this another sacrament meeting. Make it short. We told the news so he can go send the right news now. I love you so much. And I do thank you for helping out our family, and especially, I know there are some of you, they were youth leaders, teachers from primary up to now. I do thank you very much for helping out me and my wife to raise this boy up to now. So I can't say much. We don't have anything much, but once you don't know, we love you so much. And I say this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
So at this time, I'd like to ask Uncle Victor to come say a closing prayer before we go home.